Hey guys, today I'm here with a simple tutorial on lavender wreath. Come on in, let's learn the process. Here we'll learn four different methods to paint the lavender flowers. You can completely choose any one of the method to paint your lavender wreath. Please know to use a pointed but a big belly brush to get a good outcome. In the first method, as you can see, the floral structure is being painted with the help of a single stroke from the tip of the brush and a bit of the belly of the brush. Keep in mind that the single stroke from the brush is very important in order to get a perfect floral structure. When you start painting, put in a lot of paint which is sufficient to paint the whole flower, so that when the flower is half painted, you can see a gradient shade on the flower. This was the method one, and the floral structure gives a satisfied result after painting. For method two, it is necessary we take a pointed brush which is somewhat similar to this one which is shown over here. We use the tip of the brush alone to make the perfect strokes to paint the flowers by this method. Here, as you can see, we can paint out the perfect petals and the other features of the flower by the single pointed strokes. Make sure you use the tip of the brush in order to paint the lavender flowers by method 2. I think painting the lavender flowers with the method 2 gives more realistic looking flowers. Now let's see the third method to paint the lavender flowers. Here we use the belly of the brush to paint the major portion of the flower. If you want your flower to be looking like more fluffy and dried kind of lavender flower, then you can always opt for this method in order to paint your flowers. See, the lavender flower painted with method 3 looks more fluffy, so opt for method 3 if you want your flower to look more fluffy and dried. Okay, now we are gonna see the last method on how to paint the lavender flowers. First, make a stem for the flower, and then with respect to the stem, paint the rest portion of the flower with the help of the pointed tip of the brush. Here you can see the defined petals attached to the single stem of the flower. Hope the four different methods to create the petals for the lavender flowers is clear for you. Now we go for the small stem that comes under the lavender flowers. As we start painting, sketch out a perfect circle with the help of a steel ring. Okay, now we start painting the floral wreath. I have used the first method of painting the floral wreath, which I have already shown you, in order to paint the floral wreath over here. When you go ahead and paint the lavender florals, make sure you follow the circle that you have already sketched out with the help of this steel ring. Remember to bring the gradient effect in the flowers. For that, take a lot of paint in the beginning in order to paint the whole flower, and do not fill in the paint in the brush in order to complete the flowers. Then you can see the gradient effect from half of the flower to the bottom of the flower. Once you complete the painting of the lavender flowers, you can go ahead and paint the stems in order to connect all these lavender flowers. For that, I have used the green, which is sap green, in order to connect the lavender flowers and in order to paint the leaves of the wreath. Once the stems are completed, you can go ahead and paint the leaves. The leaves has to be added into a floral wreath in a balanced fashion. The leaves should not be clustered at some point of spaces or at some areas, which disturbs the whole balance of the wreath. Here our lavender wreath is all ready. I have used it by calligraphing inside of the floral wreath. You can keep it as such, or you can calligraph inside of the wreath. Hope you guys like the video. Try out this floral wreath whenever you get time and send me your efforts. Till then, take care and bye-bye.